Hello, this is Connie Belden, and let's take a look at how to calculate depreciation. In the first video, we'll go over straight line and units of production, and in the second video, we'll take a look at double declining. So let's assume we're given the following information. We buy a piece of equipment with a cost of $320,000 and a residual value of $35,000 with a 4-year life. So residual value and salvage value are the same thing. That means at the end of its 4-year life, they can sell it for $35,000. Or the life in machine hours is 20,000 for when we do units of production. Okay, so let's start with straight line. It's the easiest, it's used a lot for budgeting, and it gives you an equal amount of depreciation expense each year. So it's very straightforward. It's cost minus residual value divided by its life in years. So again, my cost was 320,000 minus 35,000. So that actually gives me 285,000 of depreciable cost divided by the 4-year life, $71,250, and that would be the depreciation expense each year. So notice in my table under straight line, I put the same amount each year and then totaled it for 285 for the 4 years. Okay, for units of production, remember the life was 4 years or 20,000 machine hours. For units of production, you use some other life besides years. So in this case, we'll have to use machine hours because that's what's given to us. So think of units of production as a two-step process. Step one, we got to get the depreciation rate per hour. And then step two, we'll calculate the depreciation expense per year. Okay, so we'll start out the same way. We'll take cost minus residual value. So again, that gives us 285. But this time, we divide it by 20,000 machine hours, the life in machine hours. So that gives us a depreciation rate of $14.25 per machine hour. So let's assume that these following machine hours were given to you. For example, you used it 7,200 machine hours in year one, all the way through 2,000 machine hours in year four. So those were given. So all you have to do is take each year's machine hours times the depreciation rate per hour, and that gives you the depreciation expense each year. Now, the neat thing about this is in year one, when we used it more machine hours, more depreciation expense is taken. And year four, where we use it the least amount of machine hours, the least amount of depreciation expense was taken. But yet, when we put it up in our little table and add it together, it still equals 285. Okay, now one thing I do want to point out is depreciation expense versus accumulated depreciation. And this will help us out in the next video when we get to double declining. So for example, depreciation expense in year one using the straight line method was $71,250. Depreciation expense in year two was also $71,250. But I'm going to go out to the side here. If I add year one and year two's depreciation expense, at the end of year two, accumulated depreciation would be $142,000. Again, depreciation expense in year three is $71,250. But add the 3 years together, and accumulated depreciation at the end of year three is $213,750. And then, of course, when you add them all together, $285,000 is the accumulated depreciation at the end of year four. So depreciation expense is the amount of expense for that year, whereas accumulated depreciation is all depreciation expense taken to date. Okay, I'm going to stop with this video here. Go ahead and watch the next video on double declining.